Hello and welcome to another video for Linux.net. Lately I haven't been doing many videos because I've been working on my website and the app list, which now lists 272 apps. Quite a lot to scroll through. But this video is not going to be about the app list, and it's also not going to be about my post-market or OS community edition. PinePhone, which runs Arch Linux ARM and way too many apps currently, because, well, the app list. It's going to be about something else, another device that runs post-market OS. And to find it, let's go to the wiki, devices, and here we go, the Motorola Moto G4 Play. There it is. I bought this used on eBay for about, well, I think 22 euros, including shipping, so quite the bargain. And the hardware of this device is, well, pretty similar to the PinePhone in terms of specs, right? It's also quad-core Cortex-A53 system on a chip. It has a, well, not too powerful GPU. The screen is smaller. It's only 5 inches instead of 5.9. It's 16 by 9 instead of 18 by 9, so a little bit less tall, and so on. It has 2 gigabytes of RAM, 16 gigabytes of ROM, so much like the non-convergence edition PinePhone, and yeah, HD, so a little bit of less of screen resolution, but the 2800 mAh battery is also quite similar in size. So this is comparable, but it's older, of course, because this is from 2016. And yeah, so let's see what this is currently running. I think it should be Android. And yeah, I'm glad the bootloader is already unlocked. That's good. So let's see how this starts up briefly. Oh god. I don't know whether this is nice or terrible. Not sure. It's kind of nice. Yeah. So let's see what we have to do. I mean, we'll need to flash a secondary bootloader, which I've already downloaded. And this thing, I think, is running Android 7.1.1. It's quite old, given that I think Android 12 is going to be released this year, and there's one major version bump a year. But, hey, security patch level from 2018. Isn't that something? And kernel 3.10. Well, but this is now a thing of the past, so let's shut this down. Let's power it off. Oh, and use the time for more size comparison. So these are really somewhat similar, right? Both have those buttons on the same side, although here the power button is on top of the volume rocker. And there, one camera on the back. This phone still has micro USB and a removable back cover, and you can get another replacement battery for this easily. So yeah, that's nice too, I think, because it makes the age less of a concern, because you can get a replacement battery for this. But now let's try to keep at it and flash this LK second bootloader, which is needed for this. Just download it here. So I did that earlier, and yeah, I'm in it. I have a terminal here, and there's the file already in there. So fastboot is also installed on my system. That's no issue. And now let's press volume down and power to enter flash mode as described in the wiki. Let's connect this, my micro USB cable, to Dum-dum-dum. Okay, it says it's connected and battery is okay and charging. The device is unlocked. If it isn't, you would have to follow the instructions on this Motorola support page here. But yeah, I'm glad I don't have to, because I've looked at that and sounds like, you know, those stupid crap, tons to read and yeah. But it's unlockable, so you should be fine. By the way, this is the XT1602 variant of the Moto G4 Play. Okay. Now, let's go for it, right? So it's simple, it's sudo fastboot flash boot here, and I need to enter my password. Boom. Done. It's flashed. And now I just need to restart this, I think. Let's power it off. And there is our bootloader already. It's nice, and it's connected. Good. Now, of course, we need to build a version of PostmarketOS, and for that we use PM Bootstrap, which I have already installed. I will link the instructions on the PostmarketOS wiki on how to get PM Bootstrap, because surfing through them, I don't have that tab open and it would take too long. So, first of all, when you have PM Bootstrap installed and you haven't done anything with it for a while, it's always a good idea to just update it. And then let's go. PM Bootstrap init. It's my work path. And I will use the Edge branch here, I think. I could use Stable Next, but Edge has more software, so renders. So it's not Pine64 here as I've had previously. It's Motorola. And the device is called. Interesting. What is the device called again? Harpia. Okay. That's the code name. So, Harpia. And then we've got a choice. I will go with mainline modem because, well, I want to use this as a phone, maybe. If I just went with mainline, I wouldn't have a modem installed and, yeah, so no telephony. But if you just needed Linux PDA, that would be a viable option, I think. So, yeah, if you are a total free software diehard, consider that. I'm also going to enable this non-free firmware, enter my username, and choose a user interface. So I'm not going with SXMO here, but I think that, well, what could we do? Well, let's go with Plasma Mobile for a change, because I've been using Fosh quite a lot. And we will enable that package for the extra apps, I think. Why not? There's no reason to change this. Well, I will pre-install Vim, because I like Vim. And, okay, well, okay, device host name, I will keep it at Motorola Harpia, copy over my SSH public keys to make it easy to SSH in, I will build outdated packages, and zap existing GA routes to apply configuration. Good. Now, again, PM Bootstrap status to make sure everything is up to date. Okay, apparently, previous update wasn't that useful, so let's run this and then, okay, everything resolved. And now we continue with... Yeah, so let's look at this, kernel-specific store page. So what we're going to do here is PM Bootstrap install next. And this is going to take a while. Now I have to set a password. I'm going to set it to 123456, which isn't really secure, but yeah, there's has to be numeric currently, I think. So good. So now we're done with this, and now we have to flash it. So let's go back here to this part of that page, and then, yeah, let's just type this PM Bootstrap flasher flash _ kernel. Okay, did that, and now we have to flash the rootfs. And that's flasher flash rootfs --- partition user data. Because with Plasma Mobile and Forge, the system isn't big enough. This is going to take a while. And it finished. So now we have to do something with fastboot again, and that is erase the system partition so it doesn't interfere. And then we can reboot. So that's sudo fastboot reboot. And now, I think Plasma Mobile should start now, if we're lucky. Okay, that's PostMarketOS. And it's starting. While this isn't a tiny phone, it really feels small in the hand compared to the Pine phone I'm used to. Try to get my smudges over the screen here. It's one of the screens that really, I think, can use some protection, because this glass doesn't have that coating that makes sure that don't get all that dust on there. Okay, and now everything is tiny. So let's look into how to fix that. And for that, I think we don't need the terminal anymore. I mean, I could SSH in to do this, but this should be good enough. So let me go back here to the PostMarketOS wiki, and let's just search for Plasma Mobile, because I know that they have something on their page that is about this very specific problem, and that would be scaling. See, I clicked that already. Okay. Turned off. No, it didn't. There it is. Plasma Mobile sometimes has this inertia, which Fosh doesn't have to seem to have. Okay, so yeah, that's all very tiny. Now let's choose the terminal app. Okay, that worked. Of course, first do something that's not as necessary right now. Haptic feedback works, which I will have to disable because I can't stand haptic feedback, but yeah. See, that's now 5.11 instead of 3.10 kernel. Isn't that an upgrade already? And now we have to type case green. Oh, this is all very tiny. And I'm getting old and my eyes are not aging well currently. Because likely I'm looking too much at screens, but yeah. What you gonna do? 1.scale.2. Fun comment. Fun name here. And that worked. So now the touch targets are reasonably sized. And we can use this as a phone. Now, of course, I don't have a SIM card in here. So, yeah, the options are limited. I could connect to Wi-Fi, but I haven't set up my little travel router. So, I might look into that all in a later video. But generally, this is the install of PostMarket OS with Plasma Mobile to the Motorola G4 Play. A nice, small old device that costs next to nothing. Again, I paid like €22 for this. That's about, I don't know, $25. If that is available, this is available in your country, make sure to get the right variant and so on and read that wiki page carefully. But I think this is interesting if you're interested in Linux smartphones at all. So definitely an option to consider. So, thank you for watching, and see you soon. Bye-bye.